Hi there, I'm Christopher Harrison, Senior Program Manager inside of Microsoft Cloud and AI, and this time I want to take a look at syntax for if statements inside of JavaScript. So I've got an empty little file here. Let's start filling it up with a bit of code. So I'm going to start off by saying const status equals 200, and let's start coming up with our different display messages here. So I'm going to say if status equals 200, and then we'd have the true side here. And in our case, I'm going to print out OK, which I'll get to in a second. But I want to one more time highlight this fact. We want to avoid using double equals inside of JavaScript. Because again, what's going to happen is if I do this, turn 200 into a string, and I say console.log, okay, and I run this, and I go ahead and I run my code, it's gonna print okay. But things are decidedly not okay, because we shouldn't have a string and an integer be equal. So my triple equals, there we go, will prevent that. So now if I run this, I'm going to get no message. Now let's go ahead and give ourselves a message here real quick. I'm going to say else, and then we'll go ahead and say console.log unknown status, just like that. Save. Rerun, and now you're going to notice that it gives us that unknown status because strings don't equal numbers. I'd have to convert that in order for that to be true. Well, let's go ahead and just punch in 200 here. And so now we're going to be back to okay. Fantastic. So now let me sneak down here and I'm going to say else if and then do another comparison. So I'll say status equals equals equals, and let's say 400. And then we'll go ahead and say console.log, and then we'll say error, like that. So now if I run this, and I run this as is, what we'll notice is the fact that it's just going to give me okay, just like before, because it equals 200, and so that part right there is going to capture that. If I change this to 400, and now I rerun this, now we'll see that it's going to give me error. So that's how our if statements, our else statements, and our else ifs are going to work in kind of the more traditional way of doing this. Now, I also do have the ability to be a little bit more terse, that instead of this full-blown syntax here, let me put this over here and we can see this now side by side. We'll just go ahead and copy and paste the code here. Is because each one of these messages is single line, I don't need these curly braces. So I can go ahead and get rid of them. And my code is going to, let's make sure I put in my semicolons, there we go. My code is going to behave the exact same way. Let me see if I can't, I'm gonna need to shrink my text just a little bit there. There we go, that looks better. Okay, cool. So now what you're gonna notice over on the left-hand side here is it's the same logic. It's just now without the curly braces. But again, you do want to be careful about that because it can lead to unexpected errors. It will behave the exact same way. Let me save this and I'm going to say node if terse, run it. Same thing, same as before, but we do wind up with that, that little challenge of there potentially being other error messages. Personally, I'm not a fan of that, but some people are. I'm not going to take a stance. All right, let's close it all out by taking a look at the ternary statement. So let's start off by doing this. I'm going to say const status equals 400. And I'm going to do this. I'm going to say let message equal to an empty string. OK. So now I'm going to say if status equals 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 200, then our message equals OK. Otherwise, if I can spell else, there we go. Our message will equal error. We'll just say error. All right. And then we'll say console.log message. OK. So now let me go ahead and save that. And let's node if ternary. And then it gives us error. And of course, if I change that to be 200, it would give us OK. Now, that's a lot for a real quick check. So I can name that song in one note, if you will, consolidate all of that down by saying const message equals. And let's put in our check. So we'll say status is 200. If that's the case, then we're going to say OK. Otherwise, whoops. We're going to say error. Beautiful. And now our code is going to give us the exact same result here. It's just down on one line. Now, I will openly admit that that's one of those bits of syntax that I frequently need to go back and double check because it's not one that I use real often. But what I do like about it is the fact that it allows me to avoid having to declare a message on the outside and then set it to different things on the middle, that I can declare it as const. It will be set once, and then I don't have to worry about like little scoping things or otherwise. And so those are the different ways that we can write our if statements inside of JavaScript.